everybody knows that it's good to be quiet in the library. Excuse me. So, what we're going to be doing is whispering and showing you some book selections. First of all, how are you doing today? Great. Okay, great. Let me get you into our system. So, could I get your first name, please? Okay, how do you spell the last name? System here. is volume 11 of Dragon Ball Z. This is where Goku goes Super Saiyan for the first time and battles Frieza. The Super Saiyan, with an entire planet for their battleground, Goku and Frieza continue their showdown to see who's strongest in the universe. But Goku's determination turns to horror as he realizes that his enemy has just been toying with him. And at just 50% of his full power, Frieza is more than strong enough to beat Goku. Gohan, Piccolo, and Krillin distract Frieza while Goku powers up for a gigantic Genki Dama, the last-ditch energy sphere technique. Soon the heroes have no choice but to hope for a miracle. So this book is a manga style. It's all artwork. Original artwork by the artists. And it's part of a collection, and when you put them together, they form a picture on the side of the books. So you could check that out if you are into anime. Urasawa's 20th Century Boys. It's kind of a mystery thriller genre based around a cult or like a conspiracy group or something called Friends. The Friends or something. And so I'll read you, this is volume 1, and I'll read you the back of this. Humanity, having faced extinction at the end of the 20th century, would not have entered the new millennium if it weren't for them. In 1969, during their youth, they created a symbol. In 1997, as the coming disaster slowly starts to unfold, that symbol returns. This is the story of a gang of boys who try to save the world. Failed rock musician Genji's memories of his past come rushing back when one of his childhood friends mysteriously commits suicide. Could this new death be related to the rise of a bizarre new cult that's been implicated in several other murders and disappearances? Determined to dig deeper, Genji reunites with some of his old buddies in the hope of learning the truth behind it all. This is by Viz Media, from the creator of Monster, rated T for Teen, USA 12.99, Canada 15. So I'll reach the back of this here. Considered by many to be the classic Rollins book, Black Coffee Blues is a collection of writings by Henry Rollins from 1989 to 1991 and includes 124 words, Invisible Woman Blues, Exhaustion Blues, Black Coffee Blues, Your Journals, Monster, 61 Dreams, and I Know You, unflinching way, Rollins shares with readers a hard-edged look into his spoken word. He is vocalist for the Rollins Band. So you can check this one out. I'll put it over there for you. Okay. Okay, so we've got some more comic books. Do you like comic books? You do? Alright, great. Well, they should be right up your alley. They're Marvel comic books. So for any Marvel comic fan, I don't have any DC. Sorry, is that a problem? It is. Oh, sorry. Well, I've got Marvel for you. This is, Gambit, the Complete Collection, Volume 1. Here's the artwork on it. It looks pretty badass. The Cage and Rage is on. Join Gambit on a time toss trip to the 19th century and discover how the Thieves Guild was shaped by Kandra and Mr. Sinister. Back in the present, Remy needs help and Rogue flies to his aid. Thanks to Gambit's evolving powers, he can finally greet her with a kiss. But as his abilities become more unstable, any thoughts of romance will be short-lived. Gambit's destiny looms as he takes leadership of the guild, assuming he can survive an assassination game against deadly villains such as Bullseye, Constrictor, Zarin, Deadpool, and Archangel. And what are Ex-Cautioner and Ego, the living planet, doing here? Gambit will finally discover the secret of his mysterious patron, the new sun. And is he hero or villain? And what will Gambit have to sacrifice to triumph? This is Collecting Gambit 1999, numbers 12 through 25, and annual 2000, written by Fabian Nicieza, Scott Lobdell, and Joe Prutt, and illustrated by Anthony Williams, Yannick Paquette, Joe St. Pierre, Georges Chante, Tom Derenick, and more. Do you want to check this one out? I've got a lot of books for you, so you can take as many as you want. Yeah, you'll take this. Okay, cool. I'll put it over here for you. Next up, we got another Marvel. This is World War Hulk. Here he is sitting on his throne. I think this took place during Thor Ragnarok or something like that. Or before Thor Ragnarok, if you watch the movies. So this is when the Hulk was on another planet or something, and in a battle royale casino shit thing. So that's what he's doing. Get behind this, baby. It's really good. Ten Tucker Entertainment Weekly. Sorry. An epic story of anger unbound, exiled by a group of Marvel heroes to the savage alien planet of Sakaar. The Hulk raged, bled, and conquered, rising from slave to gladiator to king. Now the Hulk returns to Earth to wreak his terrible vengeance on Iron Man, Reed Richards, Doctor Strange, and Black Bolt, and anyone else who gets in the way. Stronger than ever, accompanied by his monstrous warbound gladiator allies, and possessed by the fiercest and purest rage imaginable, the Hulk may just tear this stupid planet in half. So, here's what the artwork looks like. I would recommend this for the artwork alone. It's good enough, even if you have already seen the movies. All of them. I have not seen all of them yet, so this is a good book for me. But if you want to borrow it, you can feel free. Do you want to? Sure. Okay, cool. I'll lend it to you. Alright, now we got Hulk by Joseph Loeb. We've got volumes 1 and 2. Check these out as well. I'll read you the back covers. There's a dangerous new red-skinned Hulk on the Marvel Universe with keen intelligence and gamma-radiated punch. Who or what is he? And with Marvel's mightiest heroes powerless against him, will it take a green Hulk to catch a red Hulk? It's an explosive war as the red and green Hulks collide. Then things get wild when green Hulk has to stop it.
She-Hulk recruits a cavalry of superheroines, including Valkyrie, Miss Marvel, and Storm to take down Red Hulk, plus Green Hulk, Doctor Strange, Silver Surfer, Namor. The Defenders reassemble when the Red Hulk charges in with a team of his own, the Offenders. All this in a shocking ending that changes the Hulk's life forever. Do you want to get this one? This is volume one. Here's volume two. As you can see, they're battling on the back, Green Hulk and Red Hulk. Norman Osborn is on the hunt for Red Hulk's identity, but Domino beats him to it. To keep his secrets, the enraged Crimson Crusher will have to fight X-Force. It's Code Red, Punisher. Red Hulk faces Tundra, Crimson, Dynamo, Deadpool, Elektra, and others. But he decides a mysterious new Red She-Hulk on. Red Hulk's rage shifts focus as he discovers a conspiracy to take down the U.S. government and to fight it. He'll have to unite with Bruce Banner. But the uneasy alliance fails. Red Hulk's secrets are spilled, and the Hulk goes head to head. It's a cataclysmic battle that will settle who comes out on top once and for all. Marvel rated teen for teen. $34.99 US, $38.99 Canada. Collecting Hulk 2008, numbers 13 to 24. In the Fall of the Hulks, Gamma number 1, written by Joseph Loeb and illustrated by Ed McGuinness, Ian Churchill, Willis Portasio, and John Romita Jr. Check this one out too. You do. Here's some of the artwork. It's a good book. I recommend getting this to you guys. So, I'll put this in your pile. You can use your temporary library pass for this. Some more books here for you. These are old novels, and older novels in the grand scheme of time. One of them's a manga, one of them's nonfiction, and then the rest are nonfiction. So we've got the Lord of the Rings series, starting with The Hobbit. So I've got it in this bookcase, which got nibbled on by my rabbit back in the day. So we've got Sauron, or Saruman, Frodo, and we've got, you know, the king guy. So, anyways, yeah. We've got The Hobbit here. So this is The Hobbit, by J.R.R. Tolkien, the greatest fantasy epic of our time. So this is fantasy and nonfiction. The enchanting prelude to The Lord of the Rings, The Hobbit. So you've got the Shire here with the Hobbit's house. And it's a very good book. I might actually reread this at some point in time. Anyways. The Lord of the Rings is now an epic motion picture trilogy from New Line Cinema. I bought this bookcase after the movie was made, obviously, because it's got the characters from the movie on it. So, Bilbo Baggins was a hobbit who wanted to be left alone and in quiet comfort. But the wizard Gandalf came along with a band of homeless dwarves. Soon Bilbo was drawn into their quest, facing evil orcs, savage wolves, giant spiders, and worse, unknown dangers. Finally, it was Bilbo and alone who, unaided, had to confront the great dragon Smaug, the terror of an entire countryside. This stirring adventure fantasy begins a tale of the hobbits that was continued by J.R.R. Tolkien in his best-selling epic, The Lord of the Rings. US $6.99. Cover art by Ted Nash. Nasmyth. You could visit the website at www.delraydigital.com. So there's The Hobbit. Here's The Fellowship of the Ring. So you've got Frodo or something on the cover. J.R.R. Tolkien, Part 1 of The Fellowship of the Rings. The dark, fearsome ring wraiths were searching for a hobbit, Frodo Baggins, who they knew who they were seeking. Frodo Baggins knew they were seeking him, and the ring he bore. The ring of power that would enable evil Sauron to destroy all that was good in Middle-earth. Now it is up to Frodo and his faithful servant Sam, with a small band of companions, to carry the ring to that one place it would be destroyed, Mount Doom, in the very center of Sauron's Dark Kingdom. Thus begins J.R.R. Tolkien's classic, The Lord of the Rings, which continues in The Two Towers and The Return of the King. This is, sponsored by New Line Cinema and AOL Time Warner Company. America Online, keyword, Lord of the Rings. Visit lordoftherings.net. Copyright 2001, New Line Productions, Incorporated, all rights reserved. The Soul Sense Company, DBA, Tolkien Enterprises, under license to New Line Productions, Incorporated, all rights reserved. Tolkien TM logo is a trademark of the J.R.R. Tolkien Estate, Ltd. Here's the Two Towers. It looks like this is where I left off last time. Here's the Matterhorn. Fantasy epic of our time. The Fellowship was scattered. Some were bracing hopelessly for war against the ancient evil of Sauron. Some were contending with the treachery of the wizard Saruman. Only Frodo and Sam were left to take the accursed ring of power to be destroyed in Mordor, the Dark Kingdom, where Sauron was supreme. Their guide was Gollum, deceitful and lustful, slave to the corruption of the ring. Thus continues the magnificent best-selling tale of adventure begin in the Fellowship of the Ring, which reaches its soul-stirring climax in The Return of the King. And then we've got this final book, The Return of the King. While the evil might of the Dark Lord Sauron swarmed out to conquer all Middle-earth, Frodo and Sam struggled deep into Mordor, seat of Sauron's power, to defeat the Dark Lord. The accursed ring of power had to be destroyed in the fires of Mount Doom, but the way was impossibly hard, and Frodo was weakening. Weighed down by the compulsion of the ring, he began finally to despair. The awesome conclusion of J.R.R. Tolkien's The Lord of the Rings, beloved by millions of readers around the world. U.S. $6.99. Do you think you might find time to read all of these? It's a lot of work, but if you haven't read it before, I'd highly recommend it to you. It's been a long time since I've seen the movies. I don't think I've actually ever read the entire book series, but that's just me being a nougat. Anyways, I forgot this guy's name, so that's my knowledge of J.R.R. Tolkien right now. Sorry about that. I'll put these books in here for you, in case you want to be more studious with this series, this fantasy series, than I was. I'll put these books over here for you that you can check out at your leisure. Okay, we've got some more books on the agenda. This one is The Girl Who Played with Fire by Stieg Larsson, number one New York Times bestseller. A gripping stay up all night read by Entertainment Weekly. 21 million
Brandon Stieg Larsson novel sold worldwide. Intricate, puzzle-like, startling, and violent. The New York Times said, New York Times. Crusading publisher Michael Bloomquist has decided to run an explosive expose on a wide-ranging sex trafficking operation. Just before the piece is published, two people are brutally murdered. The fingerprints on the murder weapon belong to his friend, the troubled hacker genius Lisbeth Salander. Bloomquist, convinced of Salander's innocence, plunges into an investigation. Meanwhile, Lisbeth herself is drawn into a murderous game of cat and mouse and is forced to face her dark past. Gripping stuff, a nail-biting tale of murder and cover-ups, says People. Give up on the idea of sleep till you finish the book, says Dallas Morning News. Larsson is bottled lightning, buzzes with ideas and freezes with fury, says Los Angeles Times. Do you think you'd want to check this one out too? Maybe. Okay, I'll put it over here for you. Alright, this one's kind of intense. There's a movie made about it. It's by Andres Thompson. Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas and Other American Stories, published by Modern Library. Modern Library of the World's Best Books. Among journalists, I have but one hero, and that is Dr. Andres Thompson. I honor him because he reports the simple facts in plain language of what he sees around him. His style is mistaken for fantastic, drunkery's exaggeration, but that was to be expected. As always in this country, they only laugh at you when you tell the truth. Dr. Thompson's problem is how to equal without merely imitating the scholarly precision of Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas. Is really much more than a journalist, not a journalist at all, but one who sees a seer, Edward Abbey. So, that was a random book written by a guy who was never on drugs in his entire life. He just reported like he was doing that stuff, so that's that book for you. Osamu Tezuka's Apollo Song. Praise for Osamu Tezuka. Paging through Buddha by Osamu Tezuka is revelatory, like hearing the Beatles for the first time. Rochester City newspaper. His works deal with the most profound questions of human existence, says Publishers Weekly. One does not speak of Tezuka's weaknesses, there aren't any. AnimeNewsNetwork.com. Osamu Tezuka, 1928-89, is the godfather of Japanese manga comics. He originally intended to become a doctor and earned his degree before turning to what was still then considered a frivolous medium. His many early masterpieces include the series known in the U.S. as Astro Boy, with his swooning vision, deftly intertwined plots, indefatigable commitment to human dignity. Tezuka elevated manga to an art form. Other works available from Vertical include the medical thriller Ode to Kirihito and the 8-volume epic Buddha, winner of the Eisner and Harvey Awards. Covers are signed by Chip Kidd, Vertical Incorporated Publisher, New York, www.vertical-inc.com, printed in the USA, ages 16 plus, USA 1995, Canada 2495. Should be about a year's worth of reading material for you.
next book that we have on the agenda is Black Book Sessions number 3. Sketches, scribbles, full color, and stuff like that. So it's graffiti artwork. This is a good thing to look at occasionally. Smoky local artists. Published by Publicat. Publicat. And it's styly. Oh, style file. It's a style file. Excuse me. Style file. Black Book Sessions number 3. Style file. Do you want to check this one out too? Sure. Six novels and woodcuts, edited by Art Spiegelman. These are novels and woodcuts. It's got God's Man, Madman's Drum, Wild Pilgrimage, Prelude to a Million Years, Song Without Words, and Vertigo. Seen as both a master printmaker and socially committed storyteller. His medium of expression, the wordless novel in woodcuts, was his alone in the United States, and he quickly brought it from bold, iconic infancy to a still unrivaled richness of drama, characterization, imagery, and technique. And thus, the first of two volumes collecting all his woodcut novels, the Library of America brings together Ward's earliest books, published when the artist was still in his 20s. God's Man, 1929, the audaciously ambitious work that made Ward's reputation, is a modern morality play, an allegory of the deadly bargain a striving young artist often makes with life. Madman's Drum, 1930, a multi-generational saga worthy of Faulkner, traces the legacy of violence haunting a family whose stock in trade is human souls. Wild Pilgrimage, 1932, perhaps the most accomplished of these early books, is a study in the brutalization of an American factory worker whose heart can still respond to beauty, but whose mind is twisted in rage against the system and its shackles. The images reproduced in this volume are taken from prints pulled from the original woodblocks or first-generation electrotypes. Ward's novels are presented for the first time since the 1930s in this format that the artist intended, one image per right-hand page, and are followed by four essays in which he discusses the technical challenges that his craft. Art Spiegelman contributes an introductory essay entitled Reading Pictures that defines Ward's towering achievement in that most demanding of graphic story forms, the wordless novel in woodcuts. So, do you think you want to check out this book set? You do? Okay, great. Alright, we've got The Watchmen by Alan Moore and Dave Gibbons. This is a DC Comics. The most celebrated graphic novel of all time. A masterpiece, says Time Magazine. Trailblazing, says Entertainment Weekly. The greatest piece of popular fiction ever produced, says Damon Lindelof, co-creator of Lost. Genius, says David Goyer, screenwriter. Batman Begins, a classic. New York Post, groundbreaking. USA Today, remarkable. New York Times Book Review, a masterwork of storytelling, says Maxim. The best example of graphic storytelling ever, says Miami Herald. A landmark work, says Slate. Passionately realized, says The Village Voice. Watchmen reinvented what was possible. Chicago Sun-Times. No collection should be without it. Library Journal. Starred Review. DCComics.com. $39.99 USA. $45.99 Canada. Printed and bound in USA. Following two generations of mass superheroes from the close of World War II, the icy shadow of the Cold War, Alan Moore and Dave Gibbons' monumental Watchmen is one of the most influential comic series of all time and is now a national bestseller. With a major motion picture in production for release in March 2009 from Warner Brothers, Paramount Pictures, and director Zack Snyder in 300, this is DC Comics' first ever hardcover edition of this classic work. This volume features a new cover by Gibbons and contains the high quality recolored pages found in Watchmen the Absolute Edition, which are restored by Wildstorm FX and original series colorist John Higgins. Do you think you want to check this one out too? If you haven't read it, I'd recommend it. You do? Alright, cool. I'll put it over here for you. Got some DMC comics. If you wanted to check these out, Demilitarized Zone. So if you're interested in these, I'll put these over here. Brian Wood and Ricardo Bercelli. These are Vertigo publications. And then we got Decoding the Great Pyramid by Peter Lemonsure. Royal Doom, Treasure House, Astronomical Observatory, Public Works Project. An extraordinary account of one of the great mysteries of the world. This masterful full-color study of the prophetic powers of the Great Pyramid of Giza brings more than 100 visuals to enhance and expand the text into a highly commercial examination of mankind's greatest heritage. The Great Pyramid of Giza has tantalized and baffled mankind for over 40 centuries. Is it a royal tomb, a treasure house, an astronomical observatory, or an incredible, sophisticated public works project? Could it even be a landmark of an earlier civilization, perhaps immeasurable older than Egypt itself? The author explains the extraordinary facts of the pyramid sighting and construction and goes on to uncover intriguing links between the pyramid's picture of mankind's place in the universe and the religious traditions of Egypt, Palestine, India, and even Central America. So, do you want to check this book out? Yeah, you do? Alright, cool. I'll put it over in your cart for you. Alright, so those are all your books. Can I get your library card back? Thanks. Alright, so we're gonna use this card. And, so we'll be checking these books out for you. Alright, these are gonna be due back in 3 weeks from now. You can have up to 3 or 4 reservations put, against these. And, renewals, I mean. So, I hope I was able to help you out at Eric Hosser's bookstore library, and I hope you have a good time with the rest of your day, and I hope you enjoy your selection. Please feel free to stop back at this library anytime.